She should apologize to me for the lie that her husband told about me.
Dude, come on, dude. Legend, dude. God, he's so sick. Here's the top governor, Jesse Ventura, being a legit house.
There should not be one billionaire in America.
I love him. We're going to have Jesse Ventura on Leftovers, hopefully.
And I'll tell you why. Because there is nobody that works hard enough to earn $1 billion. And my argument is this. The two jobs I did.
He's such a ledge, dude. Absolute ledge. God, I love him so much.
In my life, that were physically the most demanding and mentally the most difficult that I ever did, paid me the least amount of money. One was going through Buds, and I challenge any billionaire to put up with 6 weeks of that shit at $62 every 2 weeks, you know? And the second was right before I went in the Navy. I had a job with the Minnesota Highway Department. Couple bucks above minimum wage. I worked for the bridge crew, and you know what my job was? I worked a 4-day work week, 10 hours a day, so I could have Friday, Saturday, Sunday for the weekend. You're 18, of course you're going to do that. But I worked 40 hours in 4 days on the bridge crew, and guess what I did? Ran the 80-pound jackhammer. I challenge any billionaire to run the jackhammer for 40 hours 1 week and tell me he works harder than that. No, he doesn't. That's why I believe there should not be a billionaire in the world.
He's so sick. He's so sick. Oh, I love him. And before everybody says, like, he's a conspiracy theorist, I don't care. I love him for the conspiracy theories as well.
Can't trust him. I'm not friends with anyone I don't trust. I have to have a trust with someone to be their friend. And he's the one that ratted me to Vince when I tried to unionize.
Would I vote for Jesse Ventura? In a heartbeat. I wouldn't even think about it. I illegally voted for Jesse Ventura in the last presidential election. I wrote him in.
Found that out under federal deposition when Vince was put under sworn, and he didn't hesitate at all. I told my lawyer the story, and in deposition, you could ask about anything. And so I wanted to know who ratted me in the locker room because there were no agents. No one from the office was in there when I did it. So it had to be one of the boys. And when my attorney said, is there...
Writing in isn't illegal? Come on. Yeah, no, I wrote it in illegally because I went to old folks' homes in the state of California and I beat up all the old people and stole all their ballots. And then I wrote in Jesse Ventura's name on all of their ballots. Yeah.
Mr. McMahon, has there ever been a union in wrestling? And Vince said, no. He said, has anyone ever tried to? And Vince said, well, I think Jesse Ventura spouted his mouth off about it once before. And my attorney said, did you hear Mr. Ventura? No. Well, then how do you know he did? With no hesitation, Vince went, Hulk Hogan told me. And I didn't show any emotion, but I almost tipped over in the chair because he was my friend. And I thought, but then I understand why. When we went to court, I saw in WrestleMania 3, Hogan got paid more than all of us combined. Now, why would he want a union when he's getting taken care of? Imagine that. WrestleMania 3, 93,000 people, and he got more than Andre the Giant and all the rest of us combined. If there was a union, would that happen? No.
Yeah, Hulk Hogan's a piece of shit. God, I love him. I love Jesse Ventura so much. On April 9th, 2011, when Piers Morgan of CNN asked Ventura for his official view of the events of 9/11, Ventura said,
what would you have done on September the 12th, 2001? What would you have done if you'd been president?
What would I have done?
Yeah.
I would have done a legitimate investigation to find out what exactly happened on 9/11. How did they know who did this so quickly like they did Lee Harvey Oswald? How quick they knew Lee Harvey Oswald killed Kennedy.
Because the people who did it were identified and we knew who they were.
Well, then why couldn't we have stopped them beforehand if they were identified and we knew who they were?
It was a failure of intelligence. Everyone's accepted
No, it
that.
Wasn't. We knew before with Condoleezza Rice's memo on August 6th when it stated right in the memo, Bin Laden to steal planes and run them into buildings. And more stuff is coming out now also how much the Bush administration ignored the intelligence. It was almost like they ignored it because they wanted it to happen.
Oh, come off it, Jesse.
Every war starts with a false flag operation.
My theory on 9/11 is that we certainly, at the best we knew, it was gonna happen, brother. They allowed it to happen to further their agenda in the Middle East and go to these wars. Stick to Trump impressions? Shut up. The funniest shit was a Chris Kyle lawsuit. Yes, I will forever defend Jesse Ventura, no matter what, because of how he defended himself successfully against the slanderous lies that Chris Kyle told about him. Chris Kyle lied and said, I mean, Chris Kyle lied a lot, for the record. I mean, he's a massive liar. Most Navy SEALs that write books are liars. That's just almost all of, actually all, I'll say it. All Navy SEALs that write books, except for Jesse Ventura, are liars, okay? They lie all the time. They greatly exaggerate what they've done. They take credit for shit that they didn't do. Chris Kyle was a hero, brother. No, he wasn't. How did that thing survive? Gigantic monster, awful guy. Chris Kyle protected the Capitol during the Hurricane Katrina? No, he didn't. He lied. He lied about shooting black people off the top of the Superdome, okay?
American Sniper, and I've had a lot of choice words to say about him. So people get mad at me he's a hero. Yeah, okay, he served. Jesse, you ever served with anyone that didn't tell the truth before?
They have a term for it.
Yeah.
It's very well known in the Navy. It's called a sea story.
Yeah. So having nothing to do with your lawsuit, Chris Kyle was not sitting on top of the Superdome shooting random people in the middle of Hurricane Katrina. Of course he wasn't. That's an obvious, obvious lie, right? So there's so many things
not
he says.
Not to him.
Yeah. So you sued him because he lied about you.
Yeah.
Okay, that's what the law is there for.
It never happened, and it literally destroyed my public career.
Mm-hmm.
Because I was off the grid at the time the story broke, living off the grid in Mexico. I couldn't defend myself. All I could do was Skype my attorney and bring a lawsuit immediately to stop it. And then I didn't return until May. And by then, the damage had all been done. I lost my television show over it, conspiracy theory, over that. I could not get any employment in the United States because of it. I was a pariah for defending myself, and all the time they portrayed it that I was, after he died, that I was going after the widow and the children, which wasn't true, because anyone that's written a book, in the contract, any lawsuits are handled by the publishing company, and they have insurance, and they have their lawyers to handle that. So the family was never in jeopardy of losing anything, and I wasn't out for money. I was out to clear my name, and he wouldn't do it when I met him face to face. He did, for all the courage he had, he didn't have the courage to tell the truth.
So yeah, he's the GOAT. I love him. He is exactly the thing is, he is exactly the right amount of stubborn. You know what I mean? He's such a GOAT. He is an incredibly stubborn guy. I mean, dude, you're talking about a guy who was a Navy SEAL, who then, you know, went into professional wrestling, became a governor. Like, it doesn't get any better than that. Like, he's just the GOAT. I also think he's the type of dude who could, do you think he could be president? No. Unfortunately, America's not ready for that. Okay. But the reality is, I would vote for him if he actually ran for president. I don't know. I feel like he is like our Donald Trump. He's like the leftist Donald Trump, I guess. You know what I mean? If there was ever one, like a really unique dude with a lot of psychotic perspectives in many respects, but also is like, his heart's in the right place overall. I don't know. He'd be great. Doesn't he have some conspiracy theory weirdo takes? He does, which literally I think would genuinely be a benefit. I'm not even kidding. I think that his weirdo conspiracy theory takes would make him relatable and would probably make him more likely to win. Yeah, I mean, here's
numbers speak for themselves.
Were you high when you sued Chris Kyle's widow?
Was I high? You know, that's a question, and I expect it from someone from Fox.
Just
no.
A serious question.
No, it ain't. No, it ain't, because I never sued the widow. I sued him.
Okay, well, she's suffering a lot of pain.
No, she isn't.
How do you know that?
Because insurance pays for it all. She hasn't paid 1 cent. How do I know it? It's my case.
So you stand
by
that?
The case got overturned because the truth came out. Insurance is paying for all of it. It isn't costing his family a cent. That's the way legal works if you do your homework.
Would you apologize to her?
No, she should apologize to me for the lie that her husband told about me. Why would I apologize? I didn't do anything. You only apologize if you've done something wrong, pal.
Pal? Dude, come on, dude. What a legend, dude. God, he's so sick.